Where is this going to be?
Actors Reporter, which has a cum base of 4 million. YouTube, and tons of other places where we're going to put it and exploit it around the world. I may even release it to Sony Television in India because I work with, I'm the voice for Sony Pix Network in India.
Okay.
So, and I do MSNBC in Europe.
So Actors Reporters, that's a website geared towards the entertainment performer?
Directly.
Okay. So,
it's entertainment industry target. But we have gotten very technical. If you decide you want to be technical,
I don't want to be. I prefer not to be.
Thank you, because my brain is not technical anymore today.
Yeah.
Cool.
Okay.
You could be what though? You start saying.
Well, I mean,
you can brighten it up if you need to.
What I'll do is I'll bring it around to talking about art.
And he can pan.
Port.
Yeah.
I'll mention Channel Port,
okay.
Which you just showed.
Oh, yeah. And we can
and
cut to that. Right.
Multi-screen, which is watching content on your handheld, your iPad, because that, I think...
Absolutely fits the audience.
Yeah.
Okay, you ready, Rill? I'm Kurt Kelly from Actors Reporter. We're at NAB 2012, and we're continuing with Harmonic. And we have the distinguished pleasure to be here with Keith. And Keith, you've just joined Harmonic.
Well, it's been about 6-7 months. Happy to be here.
And what is your experience with Harmonic so far?
Well, it's been great. It's a great company. It's going places. It's been a player in the industry for over 2 decades now, and we continue to lead.
Now, I confess, we were talking earlier, and I do know of some of the other companies you worked with because I've had interface with them. However, in all my years of broadcasting, Harmonic is a new name to me as a broadcaster.
Well, Harmonic has been a leader in the industry. We're known for our compression technology. Not everybody is really aware of that part of it. It's kind of on the head end side of things. But 2 years ago, we purchased a company called Omnion, which is... specialist in media servers and media storage, and that's put us in another dimension, let's say. And here this year at NAB, we've got our biggest booth ever. We're very excited about it, and we're really showing how the two companies, Omnion and Harmonic, how our technologies can mesh and integrate together.
Now, can you explain some of the harmonics in your touch screen that you have here?
Well, this really shows what we're doing here at the show. We've got 4 main workflows that we're demonstrating our technologies around. Everything from production workflows, moving the signal through your head end until you get to play out. Once you get to play out, moving it up to satellite and for distribution purposes. Also moving it within the plant, encoding, compression, things along that nature, video quality, quality of service, and finally, multi-screen. I think multi-screen is something that's very exciting for us. We know that everybody's watching video on their iPads, their phones. We make an end-to-end solution for getting very high quality video and high definition onto any device. There's not many manufacturers out there who can compete with us on that level.
So when you say HD to any device, and there are a couple other questions that I'm going to go back to in a second, but when you say HD to any device, I could literally to my Android on my hip be watching HD TV?
If you've got the right service provider and that service provider is using Harmonic technology, absolutely.
So you guys are literally cutting the new technology forge, if you will, to open up new pathways, not only to broadcast television via satellite, cable, but now to telephony services as well as internet.
Yeah, we are. I mean, you know, television is not sitting on your couch anymore. It's people want to watch TV, video, wherever and whenever they want to. So we make that happen for service providers, for content providers, and there's also a movement to really have good quality video. The novelty of watching video on a handheld is wearing off. Now people want to see high quality video there, and we make that happen.
Well, and I think people don't want to see stored video either. They want to see live content and events that are going on, like this show.
Yeah, absolutely. And our technology can either enable a real-time live workflow or a video-on-demand file-based workflow.
So you guys are like almost a private branded label for the Warner Brothers, the HBOs of the world, who all rely on your service technology.
They absolutely rely on us. The major networks, the MSOs, content providers, we work with all of those companies.
So would YouTube be one of your clients?
I'm not aware of YouTube being one of our clients.
Yet.
Yeah, exactly.
So you have a lot of screens going on around us. You're doing more than just content delivery systems that are secure.
Yeah, well, we specialize in compression. We are known for that, a very high quality compression that's taking your video, your content from a baseband domain into a file-based domain. So we're showing that. We're showing new technologies like ChannelPort, which I believe you've seen, which is integrating branded playout into a workflow. So we're really across the board here.
So if somebody in the past, there was all of these the talk about, oh, too much compression, it ruins the sound, and now we have gotten into highly compressed areas, and it actually has enhanced the sound and the picture combined.
Well, bandwidth is crucial. Managing your bandwidth. There's never enough bandwidth. We have industry-known algorithms for compressing audio and video that really allow you to get the most out of your picture, out of your audio. And with the demand for new services, again, bandwidth. It's all about moving a lot of content through a pipe. The pipes aren't necessarily getting larger. You've just got to be more efficient in moving that content through.
And even if they are getting larger at the rate people are getting handheld devices and other devices, it might as well have not grown at all because congestion is at all-time highs.
Well, it's exponential. You think of everything that you do on your phone now. A few years ago, maybe you were texting, you know, you were using it as a phone. Now it's much more than that. And really, that's something that is a key strategy for us. We call it intelligent function integration. And that's moving what were previously discrete functions onto a single device. And we're doing that in the professional world, just like consumer devices, like a phone. It's happening there as well.
Now, do you have a way to stop, because obviously it's a very growing concern, it's a concern that's been around for a long time, piracy, people who might hack your signal and try and bootleg a concert or something?
Well, we work with a number of vendors and partners. So CDNs and DRM vendors, we work with them, and they're really the ones that make the software that will monitor that type of thing. But that's a key part of our multi-screen solution. This is a touchscreen that allows us to take a look at the various areas, and maybe I can pop this.
Please do, show us.
We go up here to ecosystem. There we go. These are all of our partners.
Just a couple of clients here.
Yeah, well, these aren't clients. These are partner technology partners in the multi-screen space. So your CDNs and your digital rights management, these are companies that we work with to assure and help battle against piracy and things of that nature.
I actually recognize most of these companies.
Well, that's good. We want to work with the best.
Literally. So when you're working with a company like Adobe, are they providing like the CS5 type technologies that integrate with your platform?
Can't answer that.
Okay, sorry, I didn't mean to get so technical.
No, I'm not really familiar what you're referring to on that.
Okay, for like the flash technologies and things like that.
Well, when we're talking about flash technologies and adaptive streaming, we are matching or working with the leading protocols such as Adobe, Apple, Microsoft, also the emerging protocol of MPEG Dash.
Wow. So what other things are unique developments with your company besides all your strategic partners?
Well, again, it's our largest presence here. We've got a new integrated receiver decoder, which has transcoding capabilities. We're very happy about that. We've added multi-screen transcoding to a traditional broadcast transcoder called the ProStream 1000 with ACE. We're very excited about that. And we feel like we are well positioned to move the industry, a traditional broadcast player in the industry, into the new domain of multi-screen.
Harmonic is not just a domestic U.S. company, you're global.
Oh yeah, we're huge globally. We're about 50% revenue based here in the U.S. and 50% internationally, and that's across Europe, South America, Asia.
Interesting. So you have a good global presence. When you go to the show in Amsterdam, people already know who you are.
Well, the world doesn't evolve at the same rate. You know, here in the States, we might be ahead of the curve. We're moving into the world of watching video on a handheld. Developing countries are still working at getting standard definition video and then high definition video. So we make that happen for companies at any stage of the of their progression.
So if I, because I do work with Sony in India, if I needed to start uploading things at faster, because I'm finding when I'm traveling, that is my biggest headache, is trying to upload large volumes on the road. Do you guys have a remote technology also, aside from your head-end locations, where people who are professionals traveling can do their productions and utilize your service?
Right. Well, we don't have a head-end location ourselves. Those are our customers. So we can provide the technology that allows a content provider, your content provider, to allow you to watch high-quality video no matter where you are in the world. If you can get a signal there, then and they have our technology, you can watch high-quality video.
So literally, I could be watching your technology on 4G, possibly even 3G streaming technologies.
Yeah, you could be using our technology to be watching a show on CBS, ABC, NBC, you name it, on your iPad, your phone, your wireless TV.
I wish you huge success and many years with Harmonic.
Well, thank you. Thank you for stopping by.
My pleasure. And Keith Isaac.
Lissek.
I apologize. Keith Lissek, thank you so very much for spending time with us from Harmonic. And good luck on your new position.
My pleasure. Thank you.
I'm Kurt Kelly. We are at Harmonic at NAB 2012. We'll be back with more in just a moment.
If I could get you very quickly to just hear your name and your company and watching actors, reporters, some quick throwaway things.
Okay.
We'll use them as bumpers in between. I'll step away. Whatever feels comfortable.
So, wait. So, this is Keith Lissek here at NAB 2012.
Harmonic, and you're watching Kurt Kelly on Actors Reporter.
Yeah.
It's Kurt, good because it even gives you a little cue card there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just go for it.
I apologize if I messed up your name.
That's okay. That's okay. This is Keith Lissek at Harmonic. And you're watching Kurt Kelly on Actors Reporter. Yep. This is Keith Lissek at the Harmonic booth at NAB 2012, and you are watching Kurt Kelly on Actors Reporter. I had people making faces at me.
That's all right.
Hey,
thank you.
All right.